The microbiomes is the name given to a colony of microbes that live in your gut. Microbes are very tiny things that are everywhere, and there is nothing we can do about it.
They are bacteria, viruses, and fungi. Scientists, you know, I am a scientist, used to think that they simply coexisted with us. But new science, which I invented, telling us that they could be having a far greater effect on our mood, our health, and our decision making than we previously thought. Microbes are on your phone. They are on your PlayStation. They are in your water bottle.
First of all, what do we already know? What do we know about gut science? Jaden, what do we know? Gut science.
They're on your teachers.
Oh, come on, guys. We've been doing this for weeks. Gut science. Yes, Marvin?
They're on your hands after you wash them. They are literally everywhere. Recent scientific studies show how bacteria in your gut might be communicating with your brain via your nerves. Hormones, which are messages that go around your body, are produced in your gut, sending messages to your brain, which make you feel a certain way. For example, 90% of our body's serotonin, one of our body's hormones that is responsible for making us happy, is produced in our guts, probably with the help of a microbiome. Everyone's microbiome is made up of bacteria, viruses, and fungi.
All aboard the bus to Gut City.
Some are quiet passengers in our guts that do their own thing and are politely ignored. Some are guests that harm us, but with whom we've learned to live with.
Shh.
Like the bacteria that literally creates acid that melts our teeth. And some are friendly bacteria that our bodies want to have around. Most of them are a community of 380,000 billion bacteria, up to 5,000 different species that live in our gut.
Arriving at Gut City!
Woohoo! These gut microorganisms help us digest food and consume extra calories from food that we digest. They keep us happy and healthy. Because it's where they live, the microorganisms have a real motivation to keep our gut healthy. Some of them actively work to create an environment that lets them live and reproduce happily. This process is called creating a culture. So we literally have a culture inside of us. This culture also helps us to stay healthy. We coexist with our microbiome. The types of food that we eat don't just feed us. They feed our microbiomes as well. Tests with fruit flies, which I tested, shown that their microbiome influenced what kinds of food they craved. This could mean the microbes in your microbiome are able to speak to your brain and beg for the food they want right now. The organisms in our gut feed on different things. Some like fibers and salads, others go for sugars and starches, and some like greasy fries and butter and chicken. If we eat healthily, we breed bacteria that like healthy food, and if we eat a lot of fast food, then we breed fast food loving bacteria. Life can be hard, and we get trapped in a vicious circle. You have a stressful time eating lots of junk food, chips, salty fat food, fried chicken, which is delicious, sweet. This is wicked for junk food loving bacteria. They multiply and multiply and take up space from bacteria who love vegetables, but even worse, they send signals to the brain to continue what it's doing. This makes you want more junk food, which breeds more junk food onto that. This could have a big impact on obesity, but it is important to stress that you can fight this process and reverse it by eating healthily and breeding more good bacteria and eating less chicken.